I sort of take pride in being an old school kind of disguise actor, which probably means that my career hasn't gone further because no one knows who I am. Even at drama school, they said to me, you know, you can't sell versatility. And I've sort of spent 40 years, or not quite 40 years, but a number of years trying to disprove that.
Jim Piddock's an amazing character actor.
He writes movies, he writes television shows. The weirdest times he always pops up on some sitcom and you go, oh, I know him, yeah, that's Jim Piddock.
We're both Python supporters. Python supporters, Palace supporters, I should say. We're both Palace supporters and Python supporters. But Monty Python doesn't have a football team, but Crystal Palace, which you'll know, but people in America will say, what is that? Is that a kind of turkey? And no, it's a football team. Football, like football? No, like helicopter rides.
I have a history with Eric going back probably 15 years. We met on a dreadful film, which shall remain nameless, Burn Hollywood Burn. We were just sitting around between scenes one day, and we both caught each other's eye and started laughing for absolutely no reason, because we both understood the absurdity of what we were doing.
I kind of almost feel that Eric is putting together this comedy troupe of people that you can only have for two or three days at a time, and then they sort of go off somewhere.
Russell was saying to me he'd never done a stage play before. I mean, I've seen him do stand-up on stage, and he's terrific. Eddie obviously has done both. Billy has done both. Eric has done a lot of different things. So we're all different kinds of performers.
I love watching them deal with it and acting in it, and it's a treat for me to sit and watch them, it really is.
This is irresistible for people that like comedy, period. But if people like British comedy, this is really a unique event.